صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي آمين آمين يا رب. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. أياما معدودات، فمن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر، وعلى الذين يطيقونه فدية طعام مسكين، فمن تطوع خيرا فهو خير له، وأن تصوموا خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان، فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم، ومن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر، يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر، ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. صدق الله العظيم. Dear brothers and sisters, as we experience the feeling of the beginning of Ramadan, as we experience the living on the first days of Ramadan, we all need to remind one another that this month is not just like any other month. This is a very special month to us Muslims. It is a month of rahmah. It is a month of maghfirah. It is a month of idkun min al-nar. This is the month when the devils are chained and the doors of the heaven are wide open for those who would like to enter the paradise. And inshallah, we are all looking for that. This is a month, brothers, that has one night worth over 1,000 months. One night worth over 83 years. So this is a month of season. This is a month of business. A month of business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. This is a month of business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the month that you open a new chapter with yourself and with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the month that you open a bank account, not with Wells Fargo or Bank of America, but the bank account that you will make a lot of deposits on the hereafter, because we all need it. We have bank accounts here, but we do not have bank accounts on the hereafter. This is the time to do it. We have the opportunity. This is the season. So we all need to be part of it, and we all need to take advantage of. So brothers, when you think of Ramadan, you think of the old, of the above. So as we think of Ramadan, brothers, we need to think of ourselves here on this masjid. How to build our relationship with one another, in one hand, and how to build our relationship with this masjid here. Because masjid has obligations and responsibilities upon us, and we also have obligations and responsibilities toward one another. We all come here for one thing. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. We are all coming here for nothing but for one thing, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, everything we do on this masjid that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is blessed with, we are performing ibadah. Ibadah does not necessarily mean we are doing salah or we are reading Quran. Everything we are doing in here, so long it is along with our deen, along with our sharia, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is blessed with us over, we are performing ibadah. So therefore, brothers, we need to remember a few things. We need to remember few obligations toward us, toward one another, few obligations toward this masjid. One of them I just want to remind you, when the Prophet ﷺ says, whoever feed a fasting person, he will get as much credit, as much blessing, as much hasanat as the fasting person gets without the fasting person losing any of his hasanat. Therefore, brothers, be part of that. That is big. That is a big opportunity. So if you are part of one night, not necessarily take you one night, whole night, part of one night, and you happen to feed 100 people, even though, mashallah, there's more than 100 people comes every night. But if you happen to feed 100 people, that is as good as fasting almost 3 months or over than 3 months, because you are getting credit for each one. As much as they are getting credit, you are getting credit. So do you really want to be part of that season? Do you really want to be part of this opportunity? I think we all need to be, and inshallah, we all will be. So brothers, with that in mind, I want to go share with you a few thoughts of our obligations and responsibility toward ourselves and our masjid. Number one of the thoughts, that we should not do what's called iftar shopping. Iftar shopping means when one person wastes an hour or two between Asr and Maghrib, calling all masajid in South Florida, wants to know what kind of food they are cooking. And based on that, they decide where they are going to have their iftar. The real way to do it, you need to know where is your heart, in which masjid makes more effect in your heart. Which masjid have more influence in you when you come over here? Which imam has beautiful voice that attaches you and really gets into your bones and to your soul and really affect you? Which masjid has a good imam who can make a powerful dars that we go home and think about it and change our behavior? It's not looking for which one has a better food. So that is, I don't know. We should be aware of, and we should not do such a thing. Now, we decided to come to this masjid, brother. And all of us have decided to come to this masjid, alhamdulillah. Many of us decided to come to this masjid. The first thing we are going to fix, as big as our masjid, mashallah, as big as the parking lot is, we still have, on those big occasions, we still have problem on the parking spaces. So the chance is, if you come a little bit late, you are not going to find a parking space. What do you do? Park behind your brother. Well, we don't have a choice. We're going to have to park behind one another. But brothers, just a reminder, be generous about that. There's nothing wrong with parking behind your brother. But there is everything wrong when you park behind your brother and you hold him against his wish for another 3 hours more than he's supposed to, because you are blocking him. Because you don't know what's the schedule of your brother. When is he supposed to go to work? So when you park behind someone, brothers, when you park behind someone, please watch your car, and the first opportunity you have to remove this car, remove it. But you are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're trying to make a credit, trying to make hasanat. By blocking a brother, when there is available spaces, you're not doing that. You do it the other way around. So we need to watch that, brothers. When you come over here, you block somebody, watch for yourself. As soon as you get an opportunity, remove your car so you free your brother. So now you park your car. What do we do next? Come into the masjid to do the prayers. Few of us, as soon as you, even before you say Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, you are thinking, I want to be the first on the line to go eat food. I want to be the first of the line. So you end up barely praying sunnah, if you pray sunnah at all. If you pray sunnah at all, you barely pray sunnah, you jump outside and be in the first of the line. We are all going to eat. Why do you have to distract your brain and distract your soul and distract yourself on such event so you can run outside and eat before everybody else? That we need to change some of our attitudes, brothers. You are coming over here. You have the opportunity to do 2 rak'ah of sunnah. Do it properly. Relax. And do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you can get the good credit out of, you don't do it quick and jump out. Or you don't just skip it. Some brother, they will skip it. Now, we go outside, brothers. We go to eat. وَدَعَ الطَّعَامُ تَفَضَّلُوا يَا سَادَتِي فَجَرَ الْجَمِيعُ إِلَى الصُّحُونِ وَأَوْعَبُوا فكأنما حرب دروس إنما فيها الأيادي والملائكة تضرب من جاءك الغصن رشيك طراوة فكأنما إن عاد فيل من أرعب إن كنت أهرب من معارك عدة لكنني من هذه لن أهرب. شو في تويوتا جيب؟ The light is on, you said, or it's blocking somebody. blocking somebody. Well, if he's blocking somebody after prayers, we'll worry about it. I'm sure the brother who's blocked him, he's coming to pray. So I'm sure the brother whoever is blocking him, it's too early
to park.
There is already spaces in there. But the brother decided just to park in the middle of the road and mugging somebody. So brothers, now we go to eat. Be generous about eating. The first thing, just a reminder, brothers, that you should never take two plates, one take run to the car and one eat for yourself. Or take two, three plates, one run to the car and one place it for yourself. That is not fair for the brothers who are coming to do the prayers over here for that night. Those brothers who come here to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to do ibadah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they are fasting, they have the first priority before anybody else outside this place. So that you should not take a plate to your car or two plates to your car when you don't know if at the end we run out of food. So the brother who was supposed to eat, he just took his food. You are not doing good ibadah. You are not conducting good ibadah. You are not pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing that. So brothers, be careful. The only time you can take food out is the time when the brothers authorized says, we have access food. If you want to take, you may take. You take as much as you want. Until then, it shouldn't be the case. You are in sin if you do that. So we're just reminding one another. So now, another thing, brother. Why would you want someone else to clean your mess? Why would you finish eating and just get out of your table and walk out? And expecting Brother Nader would do it. Yeah, Brother Nader would clean the whole case. That's not fair. Do you do that at home? That's not fair. That's not right. That's not Islamic. You are not worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're not pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing that. So when you finish eating, brother, grab your plate, throw it in the trash. Grab your empty bottle of water, throw it to the trash. And what worse than that, brothers, be generous about how much you need food and drink. Be generous. You see so many bottles, half full, just walked away, leave them there, or throw them on the trash. There's a lot of items, brothers, I would really like to share with you, but our time is running out. So inshallah, in different opportunity, barakallahu feekum, Allahumma ja'alna min alladhina yastami'una al-qawla fayattabi'una ahsanah. ربنا فعلنا ما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.